celebrated for both Republicans and Democrats. Among them, the Justice Reinvestment Act.
I think the Justice Reinvestment Act was all part of helping the city of Baltimore and other communities across the state.
The Justice Reinvestment Act aims to reduce the state's prison population and give more money to drug treatment and programs.
There were some provisions that were alarming, and we were able to moderate them down. So in the end, we came out with a great product.
Another bill that got through calls for a study to determine the size of the state oyster harvest. It passed, but without the support of the state oystermen. Supporters say it's needed to determine if the state's oysters are being overfished.
This is a gigantic victory for Maryland and for the Bay. Thank you.
But the closing day of the sessions were not without controversy. Just a week before the final day, the governor introduced a bill giving a $37 million tax break to military contractor Northrop Grumman. And on Monday night, it became the focus of much debate.
You know, I look at the bill and I have to just shake my head a little bit. Mandated spending for 5 years. We've already spent $20 million showing a little bit of love to this company.
Because it's essential to keep an employer who employs over 10,000 Marylanders in our state.
The bill did survive and now awaits the governor's signature. Also among the last-minute survivors, Noah's Law, toughening the state's ignition interlock requirements for drunk drivers.
Well, it was Noah. It was Noah.
This is Noah's Law.
Right. It was Noah.
ANNAPOLIS accountability bill is now also headed for the governor's desk. It's an overgrowth of Freddie Gray's death last spring. The legislation will allow citizen participation on disciplinary boards and set tougher training standards for police agencies across the state. Other legislating awaiting the governor's signature, one regulating pub crawls, and another limiting police profiling of motorcyclists.
In Annapolis, Jennifer Munoz, CNS-TV.